Hello everyone, welcome to MSFT webcast. In this video guide, we will install and configure DFS replication in Windows Server 2019. In the last video, we have seen the steps to install and configure DFS namespace in Server 2019. DFS replication is a rule of Windows Server that can use it to replicate file servers across your network. DFS replication is an efficient multi-master replication engine that we can use to keep our shared folders synchronized between our servers. It can occur across multiple Active Directory sites and servers that live within your same Active Directory forest. DFS replication uses remote differential compression, RDC, to locate and replicate only the changed data blocks of a file instead of replicating an entire file. Thus, this will reduce the amount of network traffic generated by DFS replication. So without wasting time, let's get started. First thing is to install the DFS replication rule on every Windows server that you want to replicate. For this demonstration, we have three Windows Server 2019 virtual machine in our test lab. This is our domain controller with the hostname ws2k19-dc01. On this server, we have installed and configured Active Directory and DNS server role. As well as, I have created one OU with the name test OU, and under that, I have two users, test user 1 and test user 2. Both users are member of our security group, test users. This is our member server with the hostname ws2k19-sav02. On this server, in the last video demonstration, we have installed and configured DFS namespace with the name store, as well as we have added two shared folders. This is our second member server with the hostname ws2k19-sav02. And with the help of this member server, we want to install and configure DFS replication. So first, we need to install DFS replication server role on our both servers. Let's click on Manage and select Add Roles and Features. Click on Next on Before You Begin screen. Click on Next again. Our local server is already selected, ws2k19-sav01. Let's click on Next. Let's expand File and Storage Services. Expand File and iSCSI Services, select File Server and DFS Replication only. Let's click on Add Features to add required features. And now change to select DFS namespace. Let's click on Next, Next again, and click on Install. That will start the installation process. We need to perform the same steps on our other member server as well. This is our ws2k19-sav02 server. Let's click on Manage, select Add Roles and Features. Click on Next, Next again. Our local server is already selected. Let's click on Next to continue. Expand File and Storage Services. Expand File and iSCSI Services. And let's select DFS Replication. Click on Next, Next again. And click on Install to start the installation process. Now let me show you one thing in DFS Management Console. Here, in the last video demonstration, we have added one shared folder with the test data. The actual path of that shared folder is uncpath ws2k19-sav02/test-users-data. For the purpose of this demonstration, we want to configure DFS replication for this shared folder. But before we move ahead, let me show you something on our ws2k19-sav02 servers file and storage services. Let's click on shares, and here this is the original share folder which we have created on our E drive. Let's see the permission. As you can see, everyone have a full control at the sharing level, but I have customized the permission at NTFS level, and here I have disabled the inheritance, and I have added this entry for test users. I have assigned the permission allow, and this permission is applied to this folder only. If I click on show advanced permission, here you can verify I have assigned this permission. So user can create folders and append data. Fine. Let's click on OK. And click on cancel because we are not going to modify any settings. Okay, so this shared folder is there. On our E drive, this is the folder which we are talking about. Fine. So we want to configure DFS replication for this shared folder. Okay, I think DFS replication, sorry, not this one, the second one is there. Okay, here you can verify that DFS replication server rule has been successfully installed on our WS2K19-SRV02 server. Fine, let's move to our second member server. On that, we can also confirm that DFS replication server rule has been successfully installed. Okay, let's click on close to close this console. Now, before we move ahead, manually I want to create a shared folder on this server. So, let's click on file and storage services. Click on shares. Let's click on task and click on new share. Here, I'm going to select SMB share quick. Click on next. I'm going to select type a custom path. Select E drive. Make a new folder. Here I'm giving name test users data copy. Let's select the folder. Click on next. Next again. Select enable access based enumeration. Next. This time I'm not going to customize NTFS permission. I'm going with the default NTFS permission. As you can see, everyone have a full control, but I'm not going to modify NTFS permission. Let's click on next. Click on create. Fine. Let's close this. Let's open File Explorer. Click on this PC, on E drive, we can verify the folder is there. Let's check the permission. At a sharing level, we have assigned the full control permission that we can verify here. And at NTFS level, we haven't modified any permission. That means this folder has a default NTFS permission, which is inherited from our E drive. Fine, let's click on OK and close. And under that folder, we don't have anything. Okay, I have created this share folder for the purpose of DFS replication. Now, let's go to our SRV02 server. Let's go to DFS management. Let's right click on our test data and select add folder target. So, simply you need to select the share folder on which you want to enable DFS replication. So, if you want, you can create a DFS replication group first and then after you can add the folders. But for this demonstration, to keep this simple, I'm going to add the folder target. Let's select the folder, right click on it and select add folder target. Here, you need to specify the path of that folder target. Let's click on browse and that is on our WS2K19-SRV01. So let's click on browse, advance, find now and select WS2K19-SRV01. Click on OK. And here we can see that shared folder is there. So if you haven't created the shared folder, that time you need to create a shared folder on which you want to enable replication. So in our case, our path to folder target is UNC path WS2K19-SRV01/test-users-data-copy. This is the path of our this local folder. Let's click on OK button. It will ask us that you want to create a replication group. Now, what is a replication group? A replication group is a set of servers or members that participate in the replication of one or more folders. A replicated folder is kept synchronized among the members of a replication group. So, we want to create a replication group and that's why we need to click on this yes button. That will start a new wizard named replicate folder wizard. Now here you can see replication group name is already selected, that is based on the shared folders path, which is UNC path mylib.local/tour/test-data in our case. And this is going to be name of replicated folder data. So we're going to use the default name. If you want, you can change as per your choice. Let's click on next. These two are going to be our folder target path. As you can see, this is the our path of our SRV02 server. This is the original shared folder and this is going to be the path of our replication copy folder. Fine. Let's click on next. On this console, it is asking us to specify a primary member. In our case, our primary member is going to be WS2K19-SRV02. Here, you need to specify the name of the server on which user is going to modify the data. In our case, it is SRV02. Let's click on next. Here, we are going to select full mesh topology. We are not able to use hub and spoke because for that, at least you need three members. Fine. Let's click on next. On this console, it is asking us to specify the bandwidth and schedule. For this demonstration, we are going to select replicate continuously using the specified bandwidth and which is full. If your servers are across multiple Active Directory sites, that time you need to select this checkbox, replicate during the specified days and times. And then you need to click on add a schedule and specify the schedule where you want to enable the replication. Fine. For the purpose of this demonstration, we'll go with replicating continuously with full bandwidth. Click on next. Here you can review your settings which you have selected. Let's click on create to create a replicate folder group. Fine, all greens means we have successfully completed all the required steps. Let's click on close to close this console. Now here we are receiving one message about replication delay. Replication will not begin until the configuration is picked up by the members of this replication group. Okay, let's click on OK button and fine. Now here you can see we have a different icon on this test data. We'll talk more about that, but first let's check on our other member server. Right now, as you can see, this folder is empty because on server we have one sample file. If we have configured DFS replication successfully, that means this file must be available on our other member server as well, and that we can see right now. So that replication has been completed successfully using DFS replication, and that's why we can see that file is there. One more thing which I want to show you here is if you see the properties at a sharing level, the permission is going to be the same, everyone full control. But if you check at an NTFS level, here you can see the permission is modified. Now we can see the same permission just like our SRV02 server. We haven't modified the permission. This permission is modified by DFS replication group. Okay. Let's test something else as well. Let me open File Explorer again. And I'm going to copy some data. Let's copy this file to our test users data folder. Okay, fine. We have some data and it is, I think, nearly about 44 MB. Fine. Let's go to DFS Management Console. Okay, so now here we have one particular symbol that is telling us that we have configured DFS replication for this share folder. If we expand replication, here we can verify that replication group is there with the name mylib.local/tour/testdata. And under membership, you can see two entries are there. This is our copy folder, which is on our SRV01 server, and this is our original main primary server. That is WS2K19-SRV02. If we click on connections, here you can see the both connections are there. Sending member WS2K19-SRV01 and SRV02 as well. Replicated folders are listed here, and that is a test data, which is also published to our namespace. Fine. On this console, we have a permission. So if you want to assign a delegation to other user, that time you can add those entries here. Okay, so let's verify that whether these files are copied or I want to say replicated to our member server or not. Let's verify on our SRV01. Okay, this is our SRV01 server. Let's double click on test users data copy folder, and here you can see all files are successfully replicated to our member server as well. We can also generate a report about this DFS replication. Let's go to our DFS management console on our SRV02 server. Let's right click on our replication group and select create diagnostic report. Here I'm going to select health report. Let's click on next. Report is going to store under D:/DFS reports folder, and this is going to be the name of that report. Click on next. Next again, and I'm going to select yes, count backlog files in this report, and the reference member will be SRV02. Click on next. Click on create. And fine. Okay, let me close this. This is your report. Let's click on allow block content. And now, you can see we have total two servers in our DFS replication group. Let's expand server details. Let's expand not SRV01, let's expand SRV02. Let's expand informational. And here we can verify information about our partitions and other things. But we are more interested about SRV01. If we expand this section about informational, here we can verify certain interested information. Under DFS replication bandwidth savings, you can see that reduction in WAN traffic is 22.79 MB. Why? The original data was of size 44.48 MB. And the actual data received across the network using DFS replication is 21.68 MB. That means DFS replication bandwidth saving is 51.25%. Why? Due to remote differential compression. Using this algorithm, DFS replication has compressed the data, and the actual data was 44.48 MB, but due to that compression, our data converted into size 21.68 MB. That will save our bandwidth. So this is the way how we can install and configure DFS replication in Windows Server 2019. In the next video, we're going to see that how we can configure roaming profile with DFS namespace in Windows Server 2019. That's it for this video demonstration. Thank you all for watching this video.